Hello, good morning friends. This is Dr. P. Surendrapadhyaya and Mr. Siddhant Rao, my grandson. Both are speaking at Delhi in his own house. Now, in the part 3, we will be continuing from the last one, that is from 6th March 2018 prediction. Okay? Mr. Siddhant, please continue. Actually, he is studying in 4th standard. His age is 10 years only. And he is showing interest in astrology also. That is good for me actually. Whatever the knowledge I am having, I can actually give to him. Okay? So, my successor, Mr. Siddhant Rao, please continue, sir.
Vrishabha Rashi, you may move to a new rental house or new house itself. There may be problems in your health. Your relationship with your spouse may be strained. You may be getting promotion news from your boss. You may be getting good profit. It may be from your friends and relatives or from your spouse or from your father, government, boss also. Mithuna Rashi, your professional front may be good. You may get the sweet news. Your mother will be sitting in Purva Punya Sthan and hence you may be going well with your mother. Your children's education may be good also. Your relationship with your spouse may be upset. It always happens when your spouse relationship is good. Relationship with the mother may be bad and vice versa. Your professional friend may be having some good news to you. Karka. Your Bhagyasthan Meena Rashi is having Lakshmi Narayana Yoga and no dearth for your profits. You may be rash in your driving also. So be careful in driving. Rahu in your Rashi disturbs your mental state. Your happiness has no boundaries at all, as Gajakeshari Yoga found in your fourth house. You may be pleased in your investments in lands and house properties. There may be strained relationship with your spouse, as Ketu is present in Capricorn, which is your Kalatrasthan. Sima Rashi. Your happiness front will be having some sorts of tension environment. Your children become lazy during the period. You may be having good partnership with your father, boss, government. Your bhagya may be affected. Your karma sthan may be affected. You may be spending much in long distance traveling also. Kanya Rashi. Your relationship with your spouse will be good. Your professional front will be having some sweet news. Your Dhanasthan and Kutumbasthan will be benefited. Your courage is doubled. You are blessed with Goddess Parvati and Bhagwan Ishvara in the form of Moon and Jupiter. Your happiness will be affected by the presence of Saturn in 4th house. Your children will not hear your words. Your health is intact. Tula Rashi. Your personality is pleasing. You may be profited by the presence of Mars in the form of land and house properties by way of rental income. Your happiness may be disturbed by the presence of Ketu. Your children are doing extremely well in their studies. You may be benefited by your spouse in the form of money flow to your purse. You may be benefited by your relatives and friends. Your mother will be having words to tell and will be obeying her instructions very well. You may be affected by your father. Vrishchika Rashi. From children you get happiness as Venus and Mercury in 5th house. House front also having absolute peace and happiness. Money front is damn slow. Your Kalatras may be too entertaining and enjoying during the period. Your mother may be traveling on religious tours. You may be spending money for the religious activity. Sagittarius. Your happiness has no border. Your relationship with the spouse may be too good. Your personality may be having slowness. Your professional front is the cause for your happiness. Capricorn, your expenditure and tensions during this period may be much more than as usual. Your income from the father will be indicated. You may be expecting good news from your boss. The spouse may be the cause for the happiness in your professional front. The marketing efforts will be doubled and people will be happy because of your effective communication. Aquarius, your voice is an authoritative, you may be ruling
type of person.
Your income will be clean sweep because of Lakshmi Narayana Yoga formed in your second house. Your Bhagya is good as Gajakesari Yoga formed in Libra. Your house of Bhagya, your children may be sources of income. They may be performing well in the examinations and they may be tipped for going abroad also. Meena Rashi. Your Rashi is having Venus and Mercury being the lords of 3rd and 8th and 4th and 7th, bringing mixed up results. You are more influenced by your spouse. Your house front environment will be good. You are benefited by the investments in land and house properties. Your professional front may be having union problems. Your profits will be affected due to the presence of Ketu. Your children may be hurt to you. The above predictions will be the same on 7th March or 7th of March also. In the Rashi chart of 8th March 2018, Ascendant along with Sun are in Aquarius. Venus and Mercury are in Pisces. Rahu is in Cancer. Jupiter is in Libra. Moon is in Scorpio. Saturn along with Mars is in Sagittarius. And Ketu is in Capricorn. On 8th of March, Mars will be moving to Sagittarius and Moon will be moving to Scorpio. In view of this, predictions based on Moon and Mars will be changing only for, and for the rest, it will be as it is. For example, for Meena Rashi persons, Moon will be moving to the Bhagya Sthan and hence they will be benefited by Mother. Mars will be moving to Sagittarius causing some more tensions in their professional front. For Makara Rashi and Makara Lagna fellows, even they may be getting bad news from their boss regarding their non-performances in their working front. Even Saturn's third aspect on Kumbha Rashi and for Meena Rashi, it may be the 12th Rashi. So the day March 8th and 9th may be a bad day for them. In the Rashi chart of 11th March 2018, Ascendant along with Sun is in Aquarius. Venus and Mercury are in Pisces. Rahu is in Cancer. Jupiter in retrograde in Libra. Mars, Saturn and Moon are in Sagittarius and Ketu is in Capricorn. Here, Mars will be moving to Sagittarius and also and as
so Earth, also Moon in Purashada Nakshatra Charan 1 and hence all the three planets with Saturn, his bitter enemy Mars and Moon are also posited in Sagittarius Rashi.
Hence, for Dhanur Rashi persons will have tensions in their mind. Makara Lagna persons are having heavy expenditure. Meena Rashi persons will have to lose the job. Kumbha Rashi persons will be having profit on account of land and house properties. But there may be some litigation in the property deals for which care has to be taken for. For Gemini people, there may be differences of opinion between them and their spouse. For Gemini, professional front will be having good news as Venus is exalted and also with Mercury. For them, children bring happiness. For Karkans, Bhagya
will go up
due to the exaltation of Venus. Karkans will have domestic happiness in view of Jupiter's presence in Libra, 4th house from Karka. For Virgo people, there may be unhappiness in house. For Virgo persons, relationship with their spouse may be good except Mercury is weak and hence they may be not use their intelligence. For Virgos, there is no dearth for the income as Jupiter is in 2nd house. For these persons, Bhagya will be up due to their spouse as the Lord of Taurus is Venus and it is in Pisces in exaltation form. We will continue.
Hello.